Hi, this is part two of making soilless wheatgrass. Yesterday I showed how I put my wheat in a jar, less than a cup, and I made some previously. It was way too thick, and so it wasn't that healthy because it was just too crowded. And so I'm making it with less than a cup this time. It swelled up nice. It was about that full before I soaked it. It was dry organic wheat. I soaked it overnight for 8 hours, over 8 hours actually. And now I'm going to pour off this Rejuvelac, which I'm going to save because it's a very healthy, enzyme-rich base for making many foods like seed cheese and yogurt. And it's got lots of Acidophilus bifilus. I'm probably pronouncing that wrong. Which is the main natural ingredient in yogurt, that which makes yogurt actually healthy. And so we make raw natural seed yogurt with this Rejuvelac, which is the old way of making yogurt as prescribed by Ann Wigmore, who came up with this whole sprouting process that I'm doing today, actually. So I'm going to pause this here while I drain this off. Well, I could just, I'll just set this down here and let you watch me drain it. I don't know how much you could see as I set the camera aside. I'm draining the Rejuvelac into a cup. To use for later. Or you could just drink this straight up. It's very good for you. There's probably no better drink on earth than Rejuvelac. That's why they call it Rejuvelac. So, if you use good organic water, definitely don't want to just throw that water out. That's good stuff. So, you've got your wheat berries. And next thing I'm going to do is. Here's my wheat berries. Here's my Rejuvelac. I'm going to take these unbleached. There's my trays I use for soilless wheatgrass growing. You've got your what they call basket tray and your regular tray. And then your wheatgrass hotel, as I like, your apartment building, as I like to refer to it. This came as one unit. I bought it on the internet. And if you're interested, leave me a note and I'll try to get to you about who sells these units. I found it on YouTube, so it's up there already. And I'm going to take my unbleached paper towel pre-cut by the power of television. Pre-cut two pieces of unbleached paper towel and set them over the basket that has it's made that has holes, what they call the basket tray. And I will wet this down. We have very good natural mountain water here. No problem with using lots of it. what you stand first, because it works better that way. The wheat sticks to it better when you're spreading it, and it's harder to soak the wheat on here good once without moving it. Once it's made, if you don't wet it first. So I've got that tray wetted down, and I'm just gonna pour this out, which looks like the perfect amount this time. Maybe even still a little bit more than enough. Hard to do this stuff. The hands, the film stars, are struggling with doing everything with one hand, since the other hand has become a film, or and the one is the actress. So my one hand is having trouble doing everything by itself, so I will pause this for a minute while I get the remaining berries out of the jar, because I don't like to waste anything. So I'm looking for my pause button here, which I can't find. Okay, I'll just set you off to the side for a moment while I get the remaining wheat out of the jar. Put it on the tray, especially my tray, and the actress hand will spread the wheat, the movie star hand, hi, talk to the hand. We'll spread the wheat out nice and evenly on the basket tray. Spreading it thin this time, because last time I had it thick and it was just too thick. It didn't seem healthy. It didn't seem like they had enough room to all live properly. And when you have dying wheat that doesn't have enough room to live, it is a potential for mold, because dying wheat is not living wheat, and if it's sitting there rotting, it's dying. So we live on a high mountain rainforest area, and there's plenty of moisture in the air, so that's one of the reasons I'm going with soilless wheatgrass growing, because moisture seems to be a big problem with the wheat here. I've had mold problems. So everything I could do to avoid the potential for mold in the root systems. They say the mold is harmless because the rejuvelac that's put off by the seeds actually is a healthy bacteria, Acidophilus lacobifidus is actually a healthy bacteria and overwhelms bad bacteria, which is the way yogurt works, that you're going to have bacteria whenever anything sets out. But if you're setting it up to have a healthy bacteria, then overrides the unhealthy bacteria that would otherwise grow in its place. And our colons are kind of work on the same idea. If you could set your colon up and your entire digestive tract up with good, healthy bacteria, then it will overwhelm the bad bacteria. If you get good digestive enzymes working in your colon, then the bad stuff doesn't have an opportunity to set up house. It's kind of like the Bible says about throwing out demons or something. You know, if you clean out the house and you don't put something good in it, this is my version, of course, of the scripture. You don't put something good back in it, like more of the word, then you get worse demons come and live in the house. It's the same way with the house of our bodies, our temples, is we gotta put good stuff in them so that it overwhelms the bad stuff that tries to move in and would take over if it had the opportunity. Well, I've got all that spread. This is nice because it has these little handles on the side where you could pick up the trays, and as you can see, the water kind of spreads out there. These are already pretty wet, but I will use this spray gun that comes with the with the Soilless apartment building complex, as I call it. And I will spray these down just to make sure they have some surface topical wetness. I could see why Yeshua spoke in parables of agriculture and seed cultivation in so many of the teachings that he had, because how you approach gardening is so much a metaphor for almost everything we do in this life, spiritually and physically. So there it is, my apartment building, with another part two of how to make soilless wheat berries. That was over 8 hours of soaking, and we'll see how it does. I'll keep you guys updated. There's some mung beans on top. That's kind of an experiment. I made too much mung beans in a jar, and I didn't use them all before they started going green, so I just spread them out in these trays, the soilless tray on a paper towel. And although I've never seen it recommended or anything, I'm going to see if I could produce a batch of greens, just greens for cutting out of the mung beans I didn't use. And they seem to be doing pretty good. They should be yummy. Yummy greens. And there you go. Thanks for watching. Shalom.